multiple people handling things just to keep everybody safe. It's also our annual parochial church meeting. There are some places available on PCC and DPS Synod. Forms at the back. The meeting will be after this service. It will be very brief. We've been asked to keep them as brief as possible. Thank you very much for everybody who supported the Macmillan Coffee Morning. We've got a great amount of that as well. Can you please check that you've either scanned your phone with a QR code on the way in, or your name is on the list at the back. Either or is fine, just so we've got the contact tracing, please, as well. My apologies, it's a bit nippy. It's chilly when you've been here since about 8:15 this morning. The heating is broken, it's looking terminal, so we're in a bit of a dilemma because at the moment our giving doesn't meet our outgoings. So if we pay for a new boiler, that literally wipes out every single piece of money we have in the bank, and we're still left with a deficit from last year, and there'll be a deficit this year. So very worrying times ahead, so please commit that to your prayers and wrap up warm. We'll get it sorted when we can, but apologies. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments, and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repentant of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you with all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand for the glory. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer, for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The collect for the 17th Sunday after Trinity. Almighty God, you have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless till they find their rest in you. Pour your love into our hearts and draw us to yourself. And so bring us at last to your heavenly city, where we shall see you face to face, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading.
The Old Testament reading is taken from Isaiah.
He built a watchtower in the midst of it, and hewed out a wine vat in it. He expected it to yield grapes, but it yielded wild grapes. And now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and people of Judea, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I have not done in it? When I expected it to yield grapes, why did it yield wild grapes? And now I will tell you what I will do to my vineyard. I will remove its hedge, and it shall be devoured. I will break down its wall, and it shall be trampled down. I will make it a waste. It shall not be pruned or hoed, and it shall be overgrown with briers and thorns. I will also command the clouds that they rain, no rain upon it. For the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judea are his pleasant planting. He expected justice, but saw bloodshed, righteousness, but heard a cry. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The New Testament reading is taken from Philippians. If anyone else has reason to be confident in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day, a member of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew born of Hebrews, as to the law, a Pharisee, as to zeal, persecutor of the church, as to righteousness under the law, blameless. Yet, whatever gains I had, these I have come to regard as loss because of Christ. More than that, I regard everything as loss, because of the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. For his sake I have suffered the loss of all things, and I regard them as rubbish, in order that I might gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but one that comes from faith in Christ, the righteousness from God based on faith. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection, and the sharing of his sufferings by becoming like him in his death. If somehow I may attain the resurrection from the dead, pressing toward the goal. Not that I have already attained this, or have already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own, because Jesus Christ has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Amen.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, listen to another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Then he leased it to tenants and went to another country. When the harvest time had come, he sent his slaves to the tenants to collect his produce. But the tenants seized his slaves and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again he sent to the slaves more than the first, and they treated them in the same way. Finally he sent his son to them, saying, they will respect my son. But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him and get his inheritance. So they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard and killed him. Now when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? They said to him, he will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants, who will give him the produce at the harvest time. Jesus said to them, have you never read in the scriptures, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone? This was the Lord's doing, and it is amazing in our eyes. Therefore I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that produces the fruits of the kingdom. The one who falls on this stone will be broken to pieces, and it will crush anyone on whom it falls. When the When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard his parables, they realized that he was speaking about them. They wanted to arrest him, but they feared the crowds because they regarded him as a prophet. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. So, as Jesus tells the parable that we've just heard, he's entered into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday as the Messiah, and he's cleansed the temple. And then the chief priests and the elders have challenged his authority. And now, with the parable of the wicked tenants in the vineyard, Jesus spells out the implication of their choices. Now, in this parable, we see that the vineyard owner sends two lots of his slaves and then his son to collect the harvest. And one by one, they're all brutally murdered. A bit of a gruesome gospel for first thing on a Sunday morning. And then Jesus turns to the religious leaders and he asks them, what should the landowners do? They reply that he should put the wretches to a miserable death and rent the vineyard out to some better tenants. Tenants who will behave appropriately, give him the share of the crop at harvest time. Well, they've answered Jesus' question, but at that point they haven't quite got it that he was talking about them. That it's them and it's their actions that he's frustrated with. Now, at this point, it would be really easy for us to lapse into a judgmental mode, wouldn't it? And point out that, of course, the tenants symbolise the religious leaders and their inappropriate behaviour. And to focus on how the vineyard owner's son is Jesus, and the son's murder is the crucifixion. And to dwell on the negatives, and to use it as a parable to beat others up with when their behaviour their values don't quite fit in with our own. And sadly, we're seeing too much of that at the moment, aren't we? People who see others out and about and they don't think they should be there, or they are breaking laws out there, and yes, they're in the wrong, but people are very judgmental about how awful they are and how wrong they are, but actually forget that none of us are perfect either. But what I want to suggest this morning is that we actually look at this story of one as trust. In fact, supreme trust, divine trust in us. Because the God in whom we believe is a God who trusts us with so much. He's trusted us with his vineyard, the proclamation of his kingdom here on earth, and how we live our faith out. In trust, God planted the vineyard to sustain us, constructed the fence to protect us, dug the wine press to nurture us, and built the tall watchtower to remind us his ever-watchful presence. And then he trusts us with the tenancy of his vineyard, the work on earth, sharing the gospel with others. And in trust, he gives us the responsibility to tend and to shape that vineyard to the best of our abilities. He leaves us in control to determine the future of the vineyard. And he awaits both our loyalty and our service in proclaiming his kingdom. We need to remember that the landowner sent his closest and best representative, his son. And the mistreatment of his servants had been a slap in the face, and it did deserve punishment. But it doesn't punish them for getting it wrong. Instead, the final gesture by the landowner was a measure of his patience and grace towards the tenants by sending his son. And so it is with God, by sending his son to die for us, a measure of God's patience and grace to us too. So today, we remember and we believe that all good things come from God. That God places his trust in us to speak positively of him as we go about our daily lives. And to remember the faith that God has in us to use kingdom. Amen.
Truth, claiming for God the honour and obedience that is due.
bring to relief all who suffer, because what they need for their sustenance has been unjustly withheld. We pray and give thanks for the work of our food bank. We pray for all who need to use it. We pray at this time for all who suffer in any way, for those affected by Storm Alex, for our loved ones in nursing homes who we are unable to visit, who we miss greatly, Lucy Bolton, Iris Dixon, Jean Douglas, Renee Lucy, Marjorie Talbot, Gary Merrin, Albert Poole, for those sick in body, mind or spirit, Anita Almond, Joan Bentham, Margaret Blair, Neve Evans, Lauren Hall, Jodie Hilton, Elsie Holt, Kerry Lowe, Megan Mason Bird, the Reverend Christopher Park and Spencer Pierce. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for all who, after being ignored and rejected in this world, have entered into glory. May they rejoice in the good fruit of eternal life. Praying for the recently departed Yvonne Clark, for her family and her friends, especially for Deb. And remembering the anniversaries this week of Audrey Fox, Mabel Lambie, Herbert Smith, Rose Kisby, Fred Bolton and Gilda Allen. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray in the name of Christ, the cornerstone of our faith. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
Song of praise. Holy, holy, holy.
is the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Leonard and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Trust in the compassion of God, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many,
we are one body,
because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs onto your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to be prepared to be your Lord and Son Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, that our souls may God the Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you